Hi all, in this video we are going to see the packet tracer activity network representation. We will go through objectives. Here we can see the network model in this activity incorporates many of the technologies that you will master in your CCNS studies. It represents a simplified version of how a small to medium-sized business network might look. Feel free to explore the network on your own. When you are ready, proceed through the following steps and answer the questions. It is not important that you understand everything you see and do in this activity. Feel free to explore the network on your own. If you wish to proceed more systematically, follow the steps below. Answer the questions to the best of your ability. We will come to step 1. Identify common components of a network as represented in Packet Tracer. The icon toolbar at the bottom left hand corner has various categories of networking components. You should see categories that correspond to intermediary devices, entity devices, and to media. The connections category with the lightning bolt icon represents the networking media supported by Packet Tracer. There is also an entity devices category and two categories specific to Packet Tracer: custom made devices and multi user connection. So here I list the intermediary devices categories. Okay, we will see the Packet Tracer now. Here in this topology, here we can see your network devices. Here we can see the routers, switches, hubs, wireless devices, security, WAN emulation. Also here we can see that lightning bolt here. So this is nothing but the connections. Also here we can see the entity devices. Coming to the topology, here we can see the entity devices. We have layer 2 and layer 3 switches. We have a number of routers. Then we have WAN emulation. Then we have wireless devices. Yes. Now we will go to C. Without entering into the internet cloud or intranet cloud, how many icons in the topology represent endpoint devices? Only one connection leading to them. Right, here is our topology. We'll come to home office first, and here we can see the entity devices 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now we will go to central, and here we can see 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Now we will go to branch 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So we have total 15 entity devices in this topology. Now we will go to next. Without counting the two clouds, how many icons in the topology represent intermediary devices, multiple connections leading to them? Right, we will come to the topology. We'll go to home office first. Here we can see 1, 2. Okay, now here we have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now in branch 9, 10, and 11. Yes, so we got total 11 intermediary device in this topology. Now we will go to the next question. How many entity devices are not desktop computers? Okay, this desktop computers comes under entity devices. So in the beginning we have seen total we have 15 entity devices. So just we will count desktop computers. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6 and 7. Yeah, we got 7 desktop computers. So we have entity devices are not desktop computers are 15 minus 8. It's 7. So it's obviously 8. Now we will go to next question. How many different types of media connections are used in this network topology? Okay, coming to the topology, here we can see here they are using copper straight through cable. Here we can see wireless. Here we can see coaxial cable. Here we can see serial DC or DT. Right, so total we have 4 different types of media connections. Now we are coming to step 2. In Packet Tracer, only the server PT device can act as a server. Desktop or laptop PCs cannot act as a server. Based on your studies so far, explain the client-server model. Well, yes, nowadays we know that a host can act as a client as well as a server, or it can be both. Software installed on the host determines the role it plays on the network. Servers are hosts that have software installed that enables them to provide information and services like email or web pages to other hosts on the network. Clients are hosts that have software installed that enables them to request and display the information obtained from the server. A client could also be configured as a server simply by installing that server software in it. Now we will go to B here. List at least two functions of intermediary devices. Yes, we know these intermediary devices generate and retransmit data signals, maintain information about what pathways exist through the network and internetwork, notify other devices of errors and communication failures, direct data along alternate pathways when there is a link failure, then classify and direct messages according to quality of service priorities, permit or deny the flow of data based on security settings. So these are the some of the functions of intermediary devices. And in this step, the last question, list at least two criteria for choosing a network media type. Yes, obviously it will be the distance the media can successfully carry a signal, then the environment in which the media is to be installed, also the amount of data and the speed at which it must be transmitted, the cost of the media and installation. Now we will come to step 3. Compare and contrast LANs and WANs. So explain the difference between a LAN and a WAN. Give examples of each. Yes, LANs provide access to end users in a small geographical area. A home office or school campus are examples of LANs. WANs provides access to users in a wide geographical area over long distances spanning a few miles to thousands of miles. And also we know that a metropolitan area network and the internet are examples of WANs. A company's intranet may also connect multiple remote sites using a WAN. We will come to the next question. In the packet tracer network, how many WANs do you see? Yes, we will come to the topology here. We can see two, that is internet and intranet. We will go to the next question. How many LANs do you see? Yes, here we can see the home office, then here we can see the central and the branch. So total we have three LANs, which is very easily identified because it is inside the border and the label. Now we will come to D. The internet in this packet tracer network is overly simplified and does not represent the structure and form of the real internet. Briefly describe the internet. So the internet is mostly used when we need to communicate with a resource on another network. The internet is a global mesh of interconnected networks. Now we will go to the second last question. What are some of the common ways a home user connects to the internet? Yes, we have cable, DSL, cellular, dial-up, or a satellite. Yes, and here is the last question. What are some common methods that businesses use to connect to the internet in your area? So obviously almost all places for the business purpose, they are using dedicated lease line, they are using DSL or cable, some places they are using satellite or metro e, etc. We will go through this challenge they are given here. Now that you have had an opportunity to explore the network represented in this packet tracer activity, You may have picked up a few skills that you would like to try out, or maybe you would like the opportunity to explore this network in more details, realizing that most of what you see and experience in PackerTracer is currently beyond our skill level. Here are some challenges you might want to attempt. Do not worry if you cannot do them all. You will be a PackerTracer master, user, and network designer soon enough. So here we can see, add an entry device to the topology and connect it to one of the LANs with a media connection. What else does this device need to send data to other end users? Can you provide the information? Is there a way to verify that you correctly connected the device? Yes, this is the same challenge we have done in the first PackerTracer activity. Also, we can see the second one. We have to add an intermediary device to any one of the network. Then we have to connect it to one of the LANs or WANs with a media connection. That also we have seen. Then we can create, open a new instance of PackerTracer, create a new network with at least two LANs connected by a WAN. Yes, even we can create, we can go for a new PackerTracer and we can design a better topology. Well, that's all in this PackerTracer activity network representation. Friends, if you have any doubt, please comment below. Also, if you like my video, give a thumb and don't forget to subscribe the channel so that you will get latest uploading video info into your Gmail. Thank you.